Call OR2, tell them to stop the surgery. Do not let Matt operate on that patient under any circumstance.
This patient is just minutes away from going into VTAC. Did lab bring the blood up yet?
He said it's on its way.
Good.
Are we good?
Good to go.
Scalpel.
Pokers.
Poby.
Layla, has he gotten at least a leader in?
I'll check.
Cindy, I'm really going to need you to follow the suction. I have a feeling it's going to be a mess in there. And need as much visibility as possible.
Goulet.
Dr. Quartermain, the blood came up.
Oh, good. Hang the first bag and pour it in. He's going to need every drop he can get.
Well, I think I've got a problem. His stomach is severely disturbed. I'm going in. Scalpel. Heads up, we got a bleeder. Suction.
Elizabeth, PI.
There's so much blood, I cannot see a thing. No, more, below. Yes. Okay, I think I see the bleeder. Something is wrong here.
Surgeon, okay, I'm trained to stay detached. And a lot of people might say, my wife being one of them, that I'm almost too good at it. Robin would ream me out on a regular basis for being unfeeling, for treating patients as projects and not people, and I would always explain in my own condescending way that when you get emotionally involved, you can't make effective decisions. Because you care too much about the outcome, about who lives or dies. Emotionally speaking. And that's what I was trying to do when I showed up to work that day. I was trying to stay detached, but I couldn't stop thinking about my... couldn't stop thinking about my family.
Hey.
What do we got?
Are we keeping you up?
No, it's just... well, I'm sleeping 4 hours a night, which is great, but she's still only sleeping 4 hours a night.
And here you are yawning, making a big deal out of nothing. I'm sure that Robin is the one that's up with that baby at night.
Actually, we're both pretty slammed right now.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Emma's my baby too, especially at 3 o'clock in the morning.
You talk a good game, I'll give you that.
I think it's rather sweet.
Oh, that I'm sleep deprived? Thanks a lot.
No, that the doctor who prided himself on never making a commitment has turned out to be such a wonderful father.
Yeah, well, it's early in the game.
Ah, you're doing just fine.
Did you happen to watch the news while you were up feeding little Miss Emma in the wee hours?
Yes, I know. There's a storm coming in.
And that means that we're going to be up against it for at least the next 24 hours in the ER. So I'm going to ask the doctors to stick around until the blizzard's over.
No, not this time. I'll be on my beeper.
Nurse Mayor, will you please post the emergency overtime procedures in the break room and the locker room? I need all the nurses and support staff to stick around until the blizzard's over, especially since the doctors are refusing to cooperate.
Yes, Nurse Johnson.
Falling asleep on the job, Dr. Drake?
No, just thinking about Emma's mom.
Welcome to the neighborhood.
You did not bring me a casserole.
I couldn't help myself. And now we are officially neighbors.
You are, hands down, the most thoughtful person that I know.
I'm just so excited to have a friend living close by. And I know how stressful it is moving with a baby, so I thought you might be a little overwhelmed.
Oh, are you kidding me? I am so excited to be out of that tiny little apartment.
I'm sure Emma is too.
Yeah, she'll be, you know, once everything is all put together and done, everything will be perfect. Okay, so I want to put the lamps over here, and I have to figure out somehow to plug them in. And the boxes should be relabeled because I have no idea what's inside of them.
Lamps.
And finish stacking those shelves here.
You gotta relabel boxes, got it. You know, you're getting quite a list going on here. I'm sure you're gonna enjoy presenting it to Patrick when he gets home, the coward.
He had rounds.
Whatever, it's not an excuse.
You know, he actually said that he would take the day off to help me, but I said that I could handle it. Maybe I was a tad overconfident.
Hey, don't worry about it. You've got this list, you got some mac and cheese in the fridge, which is always my favorite comfort food when I'm feeling overwhelmed.
There's that word again.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'll say it again.
You know, have you been talking to Patrick or something?
About being overwhelmed? No. But I did give him grief for sticking him in a closet and calling it a nursery.
Well, that was mostly my fault, I'm afraid. But we'll have a lot more room here, eventually.
Once you get a plan, everything will move a lot quicker.
I mean, I can't believe we crammed all this stuff into that tiny little apartment. Put on the list, find a place for the stroller and the baby travel gear.
Got it.
I'm sure I'm gonna have to put some built-ins in Emma's.
Okay, just focus on one room at a time.
Okay, where should we start then?
Let's take care of these books. What do you want to do with these books?
That's good. Yeah, I always feel better when my books are in order.
Okay, well, I'll bring them over and you organize them.
Okay. Sounds good.
Here, start with these. Aw, sounds like somebody's hungry.
You know, since you're here, do you mind feeding her for me?
Are you serious? That's the best part. You don't want to do it?
You know, I come to think of it, there's so many, I should run some errands, and her bottle's in the fridge. Just put it in the microwave for a couple seconds, shake it up, and then put it back in for 10 more.
Well, okay, but Aunt Robin, she doesn't really know me that well. Maybe she'll just stick around and make sure she's comfortable.
Oh, she'll be fine with you. I'll be back soon.
Okay.
Pushing flu is Mr. Bishop, and I guess set him up with some PT. I want him moving around more than he is, and let me know if there's any change with cranial bleed in 14. I'll be on my pager, or obviously you can call me.
I need my doctors here in the hospital, not stuck out in the blizzard.
We just moved into our new house. We have so many boxes to unpack.
Your new house is halfway across town, and not a couple of blocks away anymore. And that means it's going to take you that much longer to get back here when the blizzard starts.
Yeah, how did you know that we moved across town?
It's my job to keep track of all the doctors in this hospital and make sure that we're adequately covered for every emergency.
Okay, but if you could see how many boxes we have,
I'm sure that Dr. Scorpio would be very happy to unpack on her own and put things where she wants them. I'm sure she would love for you to stay here so she can unpack in peace.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Is there a problem?
No, not really. It's just this whole experience has been a lot, especially for Robbie, you know, she's recovering from her C-section, she's having a baby, we got married, we just moved into a new house.
Go home.
What about the blizzard?
We'll manage.
I don't know whether to be grateful or suspicious.
I've been working with you for a while now, Dr. Drake, and I know that you wouldn't be going home when you know I need you if you weren't really worried.
Thank you. Let me know.